We are going to do a new lesson, which is fractions. The fraction is a part of a whole. I guess you can't see this figure. Okay, let's count how many color parts we have in this figure. Oh, one. Okay, let's count how many parts do we have in this figure. One and two. So this means we have one color part from two. So the fraction is going to be 1/2. Where one is the numerator. And two is the denominator. Where the numerator represents the number of the color parts, and denominator represents the number of the whole parts. Okay, in this figure we have two color parts from two. So the fraction is going to be 2/2. And from this figure we can recognize that all the picture is colored. So we can call 2/2 a one whole. Where one whole is a fraction that have the same numerator and denominator. So one whole can be 2/2, 3/3, 4/4, 5/5, 6/6, 7/7, 8/8, and 9/9. Okay, let's do some exercise on fractions. Open pupils book page 46. In this question, we are going to color according to the fraction. The first one, the fraction is 1/2. This means we are going to color one part from the two parts. Okay, now let's color one part. The second one, the fraction is 2/3. This means we are going to color two parts out of three. Okay, let's color. The last one, the fraction is 3/5. This means we are going to color three parts out of five. Okay, let's color the three parts. Another exercise in the same page. Write the fraction according to the color parts. Okay, as we said before, the numerator represents the number of the color parts and the denominator represents the number of the whole parts. Okay, let's count the number of the color parts in the first figure, 1 and 2. Okay, and let's count the number of parts in the whole shape, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So the fraction is going to be 2/4. Okay, next. We have two color parts from 6. So the fraction is going to be 2/6. Next. We have three color parts out of 6. So the fraction is going to be 3/6. Now we have two color parts out of 8. So the fraction is going to be 2/8. Now we have three color color parts out of 7, so the fraction is going to be 3 over 7. The last one, we have 3 color parts out of 10, so the fraction is going to be 3 over 10. Okay, open Pupils Book page 48. Now we are going to learn how we can write the fractions in digits and in letters. Letter A, we have 5 color parts out of 6, so the fraction is going to be 5 over 6. Okay, how can we write this fraction in letters? To write any fraction in letters, we are going to look first at the numerator and we are going to write it as it is. So we are going to write 5. Then we are going to look at the denominator and we are going to write it as an ordinal number. So we are going to write 6s. So this fraction is going to be written as 5/6. Okay, letter B, we have 4 color parts out of 5, so the fraction is going to be 4 over 5, and this fraction is going to be written as 4/5. Letter C, we have 3 color parts out of 7, so the fraction is going to be 3 over 7, and it is going to be written as 3/7. The last one, we have 4 color parts out of 9, so the fraction is going to be 4 over 9, which is 4/9. More exercise on fractions. Okay, write the following fractions. Here we have fractions in letters and we are going to write it in digits. The first one is 3rd. Okay, 3rd is going to be written as 1/3. Half. And half is going to be 1/2. 9/10 is going to be written as 9/10. 1/6 is going to be written as 1/6. 5/7 is going to be written as 5/7. 2/4 is going to be written as 2/4. 3/5 is going to be written as 3/5. 7/8 is going to be written as 7/8. Write the fraction in words. Here we have the fractions in digits and we are going to write it in words. Okay, 5/8 is going to be written as 5/8. 2/3 is going to be written as 2/3. 6/9 is going to be written as 6/9. 3/8 is going to be written as 3/8. 3/10 is going to be written as 3/10. 4/7 is going to be written as 4/7. 4/7. Now we are going to know how many. How many what? Okay, You're going to know now. How many quarters in one whole? Quarters means 1/4. So we have 4 quarters in one whole. How many fifths in one whole? Fifth means 1/5. So we have 5/5 in one whole. How many halves in one whole? Halves means 1/2. So we have 2 halves in one whole. How many sixths in one whole? Six means 1/6. So we have 6/6 in one whole. How many ninths in one whole? Ninth means 1/9. So we have 9/9 in one whole. Complete. Now we have 3/7. We are going to recognize which number is going to be the numerator and which is the numerator. In the first one, which number is in the numerator? Yeah, 3. And which number is in the denominator? 7. Okay, 6/12. Numerator is 6. And the denominator is going to be 12. 4/8. Numerator is going to be 4. And the denominator is 8. Now, let's know our homework for the day. Our homework is booklet page 39 and 40. Okay.